MOBAs are fun, right? I mean, I enjoy a couple of them, and the whole characters with specific abilities gameplay has been pretty much everywhere for a while now. Funnily enough, turn-based strategy games haven't really been a huge thing. I mean, of course, we have Fire Emblem, but there isn't a huge amount of them coming out like we used to have. Well, the people over at Trion Worlds have decided to mash MOBAs and turn-based strategy together to see what happens, and Atlas Reactor is the surprisingly competitive fruit of their efforts. When going through the tutorial, the game will probably seem a bit complicated, and while there are definitely a lot of moving parts, it's one of those things that just kinda clicks when you start playing. Games consist of two teams of four duking it out in an arena. Both teams decide their actions in secret at the same time, and then all actions execute in a phase order. There are four phases. There's prep, which is things like buffs and traps. There's dash, which are movements that can sometimes also be attacks. There's blast, which is the main attack phase. And then there's movement, which is movement. All actions that go down play out in a sequential order, but they all resolve at the same time. So if you get dealt enough damage to kill you during the blast phase, you'll still get to do your attack unless you get hit a bit more. In a game like this, teamwork is key. You need to plan out moves quickly due to the time limit with your teammates and try to predict what the enemy is gonna do. There doesn't seem to be any voice chat in game, but there is a text chat, and you can actually see the moves your teammates are going to do before they execute them. This actually helps out quite a bit when it comes to working with a team that you can't adequately communicate with, and if you pay enough attention to what they do, then you can actually learn some tricks for whatever character they're playing. Speaking of characters, I love the visual and mechanical designs of all of them that I've seen in Atlas Reactor. They're all varied and have a boatload of personality behind their designs, animations, and voices. The moves are all incredibly varied and give the characters their own feels. Overall, the heroes are well executed and easy enough to learn once you know the base mechanics of the game. I think one of the more interesting parts of Atlas Reactor is its payment system. You can play the game for free, but you only get access to the heroes that are available in a free weekly rotation, and you can't unlock additional heroes. Then there are three different tiers for purchasing, starting at a base of 20 and going up to 100. Each tier gives you access to all the heroes now and forever, but the higher tiers get you some boosters and skins for more characters. It's really clever for Trion to decide to let people play the game for free, even if it's in such a limited way. There's always plenty of characters to try out, and it seems like there's always at least one support available for free, so no team should ever really be without a support. It's definitely enough to decide if you want to play it for free or go full on and purchase the game, and I really like that. All in all, Atlas Reactor is a creative and interesting PvP game that's really unlike any one game that I've played before, and I've been enjoying it a lot. You can find it on Steam and play it for free for a bit, so hey, might as well give it a shot, right? Thanks for joining me for this episode of Indie Bytes. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please remember to leave a like and subscribe for more stuff like this. Be sure to check out the other content that we put out on this channel, and remember to drop me a line here on Twitter or through email with any game recommendations that you've got. You can find all that stuff down in the description below. I'll see you next time. Bye!